So let us start off with box and whisker plots. So this is the thumbnail for box and whisker plot, as I was telling you in the on the show me part. How to create a box and whisker plot is again very easy. You just have to select. Box and whisker plot is also used for distribution analysis of, like in histogram, we have seen the peak. This is the peak in the data. So these are the range of values where we have the maximum observations, a lot of observations. If you want to divide this data into quartiles, if you want to divide your overall data into four quarters, depending on the type of values that they are holding, and you want to perform distribution analysis on the data, then we go for box and whisker plot. How a box and whisker plot is created is, let us say I want to create a box and whisker plot to show the discounts being offered across different segments and different regions. I'm interested in analyzing the discounts being offered across different segments and different regions. Now this question I can answer by creating a simple bar chart, which will, it will tell me that what is the discount being offered across different regions in different segments. Let us go for average discounts. The numbers will be smaller to keep. Let us go for average discount. I can represent the same data using any of the techniques, that any of the views that are available on the show me panel. I can choose any option here. However, if I decide to choose box and whisker plot, then I simply have to click on the box and whisker option and Tableau will create the box and whisker plot for us. Okay, Tableau has created the box and whisker plot. You can change the fit to entire view so that it occupies the whole canvas. How to read a box and whisker plot and what is the information this box and whisker conveys is what we will see now. Box and whisker, by default, it is also called as a 5-point summary chart because there are five things that it will reveal instantaneously about your data. First thing box and whisker will convey is it will tell us what is the minimum value for that measure for which we have created the box and whisker plot. It will tell us what is the minimum value. Then it will tell us what is the first quartile. Minimum value is this data point. Okay, there's a data point here. This is the box, okay, and you have two lines extending outside. There is one going below and there is one line at the top edge, at the top end of the box, which is going up. These lines are called as whiskers. From the lower end of the box, there is a line going downwards, and from the upper end of the box, there is a line going upwards. These lines are called as whiskers, hence the name box and whisker plot. It will tell you what is the minimum value of the measure that you're trying to observe by creating a box and whisker plot. It'll tell you what is the minimum value and it'll also tell you what is the maximum value. Two things, okay? Apart from that, it'll tell you what is the median of the data. Median is nothing but the middle value in the data source. We will look at it with examples. It'll tell you what is the median of the data. Then the box itself, it basically divides the data into four quartiles. It divides the data into four quartiles. So the lower quartile is nothing but your first quartile. First quartile is nothing but the lower quartile. It is also called as the lower hinge. So from the low minimum value to the lower end of the box, 25 percentile of your data is covered. It shows the first 25 percentile of the data distribution, the minimum value to the upper quartile. This is called as the upper quartile or the third quartile or the upper hinge. So from the minimum value to the upper quartile, it will talk about 75 percentile of data distribution. Okay, 75 percentile of the data distribution. So what is, how much data, what distribution of data is the box itself going to talk about? The box itself contains 50 percentile of the data distribution. Okay, 50 percentile of the data distribution is shown in the box. So this box is nothing but the peak in your data. When you compare it with a histogram, whatever comes up as the peak in your data, which contains maximum number of observations, that is nothing but the box. Middle 50 percentile of the data distribution comes up in the box. Middle 50 percentile. It conveys 50 percentile of the data, but which 50 percentile? Lower 50 percentile or upper 50 percentile or the middle 50 percentile? It conveys about or the data that covers middle 50 percentile of the data. From the upper end of the box to the maximum value is the remaining 25 percentile of your data. Just think that your data, overall data is 100 percentile and overall data is broken down into four quarters. Quartile 1, quartile 2, quartile 3. Okay, so those lines are dividing your data into four quartiles. From the minimum to the lower end of the box, 25 percentile, lower 25 percentile of the data. From the minimum to the upper end of the box, 75 percentile of the data distribution, which makes the box itself convey what is the middle 50 percentile of your data distribution. From the upper end of the box to the maximum value, the remaining 25 percentile of the data distribution. Apart from conveying these 5 points, minimum, maximum, first quartile, second quartile, and median. Median is nothing but Q2, second quartile. Q1 is your first quartile. Q3 is your third quartile. Okay, apart from this, if at all there are any outliers in the data, then that will also come up. How do we know that a data point is an outlier? Assume there is a data point here. A data point that is not a part of your box and whisker plot, that is either not, that is neither on the in the box on the or on the whiskers. Okay, so a data point which is not a part of your box and whisker, which is beyond the range of box and whisker, it could be on the upper side or it could be on the lower side, anywhere. A data point that is beyond your box and whisker plot, those data points are called as outliers. Outlier, simply if I have to define it, it is just a value that is either way above or way below the normal range of values or the acceptable range of values for that measure. Okay, something that is extremely high or something that is extremely low. Outliers are simply extreme values. The data source may or may not contain outliers. If at all an outlier is present, Tableau will reveal it instantaneously. How? They will not be included on your box and whisker plot. So the only visualization in Tableau which will come up with the list of outliers that is present on the show me panel, which comes up with the list of outliers in your data, is box and whisker plot. Okay, let us create a box and whisker plot and then understand the concept further. So we have created a box and whisker plot. All I did was selected discount, segment and region, and you can simply go to the show me panel and click on the box and whisker option and the plots will be done. Tableau will create the box and whisker plots for us. Here, how to read this chart? What is the information this chart is conveying? How do I read this chart? So when you hover your mouse towards the chart itself, you will get all the statistics pertaining to it. The minimum value, the maximum value, the lower hinge or lower quartile, upper hinge or upper quartile, and median of the data. 5 points that it reveals, 5 point summary chart. Now here everything is in terms of decimals. So just for ease of calculation, to perform the calculations, I will convert it to percentages. To convert the decimals into percentages in Tableau, it is pretty simple. You just have to format it. So right click on the view and select the option format. Here you have to tell Tableau exactly what you're trying to format. I want to format the average discount values that are present on the chart. And what do I want to format is go to pane. You have to, for access will get formatted automatically. You can go to pane and here the numbers I want to format. I want to change the numbers to come up as percentages. Okay, and percentage with zero decimal values. So if you, okay, let us format the axis also. Go to axis, go to numbers, change it to percentage, and reduce the number of decimal places to zero. So axis is formatted and your values also, we have already formatted them. Okay, so how do you format, convert decimals into percentages? Is simply you format it, format the axis and format the numbers on the panel. Now everything is in terms of percentages, so it will be easy for me to perform the calculations. Here in this box and whisker plot that we have created, there are no outliers. Clearly there is no data point which is not joined by the box and whisker. All of them are a part of your box and whisker itself. So there are no outliers here. If at all there are any outliers, then you will find the data points either on the lower side or the upper side.